Hi guys, this is going to be a quick look at, finally, the KV2. The namesake of my channel. This beast, I fell in love with this on World of Tanks, and I thought I'd finally have a look at it in War Thunder. I don't know how this is going to go, but it's a beastie tank. It's got a massive reload. 37 seconds, and that's with a pretty damn good crew in it as well. We'll see how it goes. So this thing, it's a heavy tank, and it's got a 152mm, I suppose, howitzer, cannon, whatever you want to call it. And basically its main sort of use in the game would be for one-shot killing things. It's ironically, even though the accuracy is very poor, it's actually a very good sniper due to the fact that it's got such a long reload and it tends to one-shot kill things. So let's see how it goes. This thing is a slow lumbering. Hopefully I'll give you an example of what it's like if it hits a big thing. I attempted, if you're wondering about the dodgy bait on the side, I attempted to camouflage it with as much black as possible. I attempted to do some simulation of the game, so you don't have a massive red banner on your head telling you where you are. Trying to aim with this shell, it's got so much shell drop, it's ridiculous. You really do have to get used to that before you're able to move on to simulation. So I've got to do the white cross with the big shell drop. So you have to do the shotgun and just go in really close and see how that works out for you. But with this heavy tank, obviously, it's only one tank in the entire game. That's what I'm talking about. So now you get to see this monstrous reload coming in front of the costume, and it's a pretty good game mode. So this tank, they tend to shoot your turret as a massive target, so whenever someone shoots you, usually either your gun, AI, points is points, so either they'll disable your turret, which is a massive problem in this thing, or they'll hit your gun or something nasty like that and knock it out, obviously. What with your reload being terrible anyway. These things take a hit as well, the tigers. Or they'll hit the ammunition load, which is housed nicely in the turret as well, so it tends to be just negative things when this thing gets hit, but my god, I'm gonna get right. Tigers is interesting, it doesn't insta-kill tigers all the time. It damages them, so the majority of the time you've got enough time to reload before they're actually capable of fighting again. But sometimes you'll get really unlucky and hit them on a hard hit with armor or something. Tigers, and any any other tank if you hit them far enough. So this, if you're fed up with flinking away with the small Britons or German guns, well, low tier Russian guns, this is a refreshing piece of dirt for you. It's relatively easy to come across as well. It's just a couple of heavy tanks on the Russian side, and got yourself a massive 152 cannon. I'm going to be doing a review on the SU-152 as well, which is another massive dirt machine. That thing, the AP rounds, I've had quite a lot of success with the SU-152. It tends to have quite a specific shell. The shell for this stage is an anti-war concrete thruster. It's got a massive amount of penetration. Touching that, oh, this is going to hurt. Okay, let's try and get away from the wall box ourselves. This is going to hurt. Okay. Let's see. I know there's stuff behind me. But I'm hoping. Target undamaged. Okay, that's game over. Right, well, if this is as short-lived as I think it's going to be, I'll definitely be putting up another video showing you how beautiful this thing is. I'm not very good at, I'll give you a view of the SU-152 as well. I'm not very good at, as I've said before in other videos, I'm not very good at editing videos at the moment, so I'm trying to educate myself. So all of these videos are just the bare file, you know, editing that makes it almost like it isn't like what I'm doing. I'm playing and talking, so I'm playing. So yeah, hopefully soon I'll get to it with the that thing and I'll be able to chat together quite a few different bits of that thing utterly annihilated. So as you saw, it popped. I'm going to get my ammo for a use. This thing is a nice thing. This is a nice tank. It's very maneuverable for the size of the gun it's climbing around. So, but obviously, lack of time means that I'm not able to point it wrong. Oh, that gun still is effective. Now, this has a mildly better reload, it's about 10 seconds-ish better than the KV2, so that's definitely a positive. And it's still as effective, if not more so. It seems like it's a little more accurate. You can see that this thing is just as popular as the KV2. So I'll go around to look at this one now.
On the enemy, they're winning.
Okay.
Enemy forces
Very nice. Very nice. Did have a turret elevation speed.
Oh well.
Well, you saw even in that very small clip how effective it can be once it hits the target, and if you manage to get a lot of two very special tanks that I enjoy a lot. There will be much more on these tanks, and I hope to add a couple of clips. What I might do next time, straight away, I'd like to stop the video and add some video to the end of my video. So, yeah, thanks for watching, and
if we don't do something fast, the enemy will win.